Hello everyone. So today I'm going to talk about a poem, Names, which is written by Derek Walcott. So first of all, I would like to start with the background or about the poem. So this poem is dedicated to Edward Braithwaite, who was a good friend of Derek Walcott. And in this poem, Derek Walcott expresses his journey both into his racial and subjective consciousness, that how he faced the racial segregation and how he feels the identity crisis. Secondly, it talks about colonization and slavery, and the particular island he'll be talking about is the Caribbean island, where many people from different countries like Dutch, French were colonized by British, and they were imported there as a labor force, as the motive of slavery. Therefore, that island showed a hybrid or intermixed culture of all the nations and all the people that were transferred there or went through the sea there, lost their identity, lost their culture, and lost their heritage. They lost even the memories of their homeland. So clearly, there was no history in their mind and no future to rely on. Now, starting with the first four lines, my race began as the sea began, with no nouns and with no horizon. My race began as the sea began. He is using simile to show that his race history goes far along, that the history of his race goes far along. And second annotation can be said that his own race of running to find his identity. Another thing one can say is that the sea here is referred to the medium through which the people were transferred or were brought to this Caribbean island. With no noun. Noun here means no identity, culture, heritage, and hope. Basically, it stands for no identity, that right now he doesn't know about his ancestors, his history, his heritage. So he says that I don't have an identity because of the hybrid culture he's born and brought up. With pebbles under my tongue, with a different fix on the stars. So pebble under the tongue shows the voicelessness and the human inhuman conditions they were forced to live in. And secondly, it also shows that in ancient times, it was a technique used by the orators to speak distinctly or properly. So small stones were put in their mouth and the speaker used to enunciate the word clearly. Now the last line, that is the fix on the stars, that how they were constantly gazing in the stars in the hope that things might change. Fix also shows, the word fix emphasizes that how their gloomy condition or how their condition as a slave was not changing. The next lines are, but now my race is here. Here is referred to the Caribbean island. In the sad oil of Levantine eyes, in the bags of Indian field, I begin with no memory, I begin with no future, but I looked for the moment when the mind was half by horizon. So sad oil that is grown abundantly in the Mediterranean Sea. So the poet has used her transferred epithet to describe that people were feeling nostalgic for their homeland. Here the flags here have been referred to the victory on the land of India by the colonizers. Then he says, I begin with no memory, I begin with no future. No memory, that I don't have any history, and because of that, I don't have any future. Because of no history, it is a result that I'm not able to associate myself with anyone. So he's trying to say that being a new world poet, there are no history, no noble and heroic memories to derive inspiration from. So the new world as a whole, and the Caribbean in particular, is devoid of history and memory, and the available fragments of history are not worth remembering, as they are too painful and counterproductive as far as aesthetic sensibility is concerned. So he says that if a person has memory also, that memory is of slavery and brutality of colonizers. So clearly they don't have any good memory, and because of that they don't have any inspiration to move on or to see a good future for them. But I looked for that moment when the mind was halved by horizon. Mind was halved into horizon, half here. He's telling that how world is divided into black and white, that how the racial segregation has started on the basis of the color. And so now he perceives that the world has indeed been divided into white and black by colonial history, language, education, and racial prejudice. That how every person sees other person only in two types. One is the black and another is the white. So every world is divided into two halves. I have never found that moment when the mind was halved by horizon. That is a repeated line that he's emphasizing, that the world has been divided and only on the basis of racial prejudice. From the goldsmith from Benares, the stone cut of a canton, as the fish line sinks the horizon, sinks in the memory. So he has referred to three occupations here: goldsmith, stone cutter, and fish line. Goldsmith, stone cutter. So he's telling that in the Caribbean island, there were many variety of culture and variety of profession to be seen, who were basically reduced to the identity of slave only, who were working for the British Empire. The three cities that has been referred are Benares, which was the holy city of India, Canton, that was the silk city of China, and Benin. These three cities were famous for the riches, but now they have lost everything because of colonizers' exploitation. So he says that people as well as the places have been exploited and nothing has remained the same. As a fish line sinks the horizon, sinks in his memory. So he says that everything has been faded and every memory has been faded. Have we melted into a mirror, leaving our souls behind? So he says that like a mirror, a glass is melted and formed a mirror. Similarly, he shows that the Britishers have perfectly molded the slaves according to their needs, and as a result, they have forgotten who they actually are. So they are completely in the mold or in the hand of British Empire, and they don't have a and they don't have words of their own, neither a profession of their own. Again, the repeated line: the goldsmith from Benares, the stonecutter from Canton, and the bronzesmith from Benin. The next line are, a sea eagle screams from the rock, and my race begin like the osprey with that cry. So here he has used the animal imagery to show how colonizing was equivalent to hunting. Sea eagle is referred to the people who were colonized and are helplessly screaming for freedom, while osprey is basically a large bird who prey on fishes. So colonizers are osprey who are hunting every other country or every next country to colonize. With that cry, the terrible vowel that I here stands for the cry for identity. How the poet, that is Derek Walcott, is feeling identity, identity crisis, and all he can think about his past, his present, as well as future, who he is unable to see perfectly. Also, this I is literally the sound of scream I, and it is an agonized voice raised in a shrill and assertive cry. This I can also be seen as a pun on the word eyes. So according to the poet, the people have closed their eyes and accepted their fate. So clearly the people of Caribbean island have stopped thinking about their past, and they have equally stopped thinking about their future and accepted that their fate, that they are slaves and will remain one till they live. Behind us all the sky folded as history folds over fish line, and the foam foreclosed with nothing in our hands. So sky folded here means, in the first line, it means they feel that the sky is collapsing. So Walcott feels that the good memories of the past and present are only in a gloomy experience. Sky folded also means that the stormy weather. So he's expressing his emotions with the nature and saying that everything seems to be gloomy, whether it is present, past, or future. Here the form foreclosed shows how they were barred from all the good employment because they were reduced to the only job of slave, and as a result, all the good employment opportunity this shows that how they were barred from all the good employment opportunity because they were initially seen as slaves and later someone as inferior. So initially they were colonized, and when they gained freedom, they were seen as someone inferior. So in all, in past also they suffered, in the present also they suffered, and they see future as something gloomy. Nothing in our hands but this stick to trace our names on the sand, which the sea erased again to our indifference. So he's saying, just like a small child write a name in the sand of the sea, similar to that, he and his race are writing or trying to find their identity. But both the act of the child as well as their act is futile because they cannot trace back to the initial state. So the poet feels that it has turned into a fact that the fate of an oppressed people must be dictated just as a nature dictates the lives of men living close to it. So he's trying to say, like a small child cannot control the waves of the sea, similarly, they are not able to find their identity or their history. So he's comparing both the things, a child who's writing the name and their struggle to find their name, that is the identity. So thank you for watching my video. And if you want us to make a video on any particular topic, whether it is an essay, novel, drama, or anything, please do comment in the comment box and do like and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.